name is Tamer Nassar. I'm the saxophone player with the Raseef band, Italo-Palestinian group. We started off in Ramallah, Palestine in 2011. We moved to Italy in 2014 and we are based in Genoa ever since. First, we moved, me and the clarinet player, we moved to Italy in 2013 to study at the conservatory there. 1 year later, the tuba player and the trombone player followed us as well. There we met with trumpet player. Our friend from the Golan Heights, from the occupied Golan Heights, came to study as well, the guitar player Ala. And that's when Raseef took this new step in the journey of being musicians there in Genoa. The style we play is actually very uncommon, especially in the Arab world, because the concept of a brass band in classical Arabic music, it doesn't exist. We call what we do Arab brass. We are the first Palestinian group that plays wind instruments. We are the first Palestinian group that plays street music. We played in the streets of Ramallah, we played in the streets of Genoa, Nablus, Jerusalem, many other cities in Europe and Italy. First, it was an imitation to Balkan fanfare bands. We played many pieces for Goran Bregovic and other musicians from Serbia and Macedonia. As we matured and as we continued with our journey as musicians, as individual musicians, and as we grew up, we realized that we can create our own sound using that individuality within each of us. To put it in the collective, it's not like any other genre where you need to be a jazz musician to play in a big band, you need to be a classical musician to play in a wind quintet. No, in our case, it's you can be a classical musician and you can put that classical knowledge into the group. You can be an extreme radical jazz improviser and put that radicalism in the group. You can be a very classical Arabic, Turkish soloist and you can put that in the group. So each individual within the group managed to create the general sound and the collective we call Raseef now. Released our first album in 2018. It's called Mina Zena. It was our first project, and basically it's a documentation to the first period and the first part of our musical journey as a group. At the moment, we are doing many other projects, but they are all still in the research phase because we're doing our own personal research of sound for the group to write our music in our own style. We are also doing another type of documentation by creating a bridge between Palestinian heritage music, old music, antique music, with the youth, with the young people, because it's something every musician should do, I think, to close that gap between the youth and the heritage. I think that's one of our goals, and we are going to work on that. But they're all still in research phase. And I believe that projects and the platforms like Visa for Music is very essential. It's a stepping stone to every musician, every upcoming musician who's not doing pop, who's not supported by huge corporational music industry firms. Visa for Music is giving us that hope that even small groups can make it in this world, and they give us the opportunity and the chance to perform and play to everyone in the music industry, from journalists to managers to booking agents to producers to other musicians, which also helps us get that connection which musicians sometimes lack because of the lack of resources. Visa for Music provides that.